Now to the latest in the story that we have been following for more than 2 weeks now, the investigation into the Barahona family. Right now, we know that the 10-year-old boy found soaked and burned by chemicals and seizing inside a pickup truck on the side of I-95 is out of the hospital. Meanwhile, DCF continues to look into whether he and his twin sister, who was found dead in the back of that truck, should have been in their home at all. Here's a live look at the scene outside the home in Southwest Miami-Dade where the twins lived with their adoptive parents, Carmen and George Barahona. You can see a memorial has been set up there. The question DCF wants to answer now is, will we ever understand what actually went on inside the home? Angela Rozier joins us live from the home with some just released brand new information. Angela?
That's right, Tiffany. We are learning that there was another call made to the DCF abuse hotline. Now, this abuse, alleged abuse, happening here at the Barahona home in Southwest Miami-Dade. We're told that phone call was made just days before the Barahona twins and their adopted father were discovered at I-95. DCF has released another call made to its abuse hotline. This call was made on February 12th, just 2 days after a therapist called to report that a relative witnessed the twins being abused inside their Southwest Miami-Dade home. This most recent caller, who appears to know the Barahona family, talked about seeing adopted father George Barahona and his 10-year-old adopted son on Valentine's Day weekend. He told the operator the boy had bruises on his face and his twin sister was not with him.
The little boy that he's carrying with him showed signs of a wound around his face or mouth, which he claimed that the boy fell, but I don't really, that's the story.
The head of DCF met with reporters Wednesday morning and says the independent review panel continues to look into the case. He also admits he's still trying to understand how this could happen.
Were these people bad, you know, back when they were originally adopting, or did something happen that, you know, changed their life that caused them to act in the ways they did? You know, I don't know the answer to that. I'm not sure this investigative team's going to answer that. I'm not sure the criminal investigation is going to answer that, but it's something we're still all looking at and trying to determine if we can understand it better.
And that head of DCF, he also says that even though the internal review team is still investigating this case and will meet again tomorrow and will meet again next week, they've already made some operational changes with some of their procedures. One has to do with the Miami-Dade Police Department. They shortened the amount of time it takes for them to contact the police when there is a case of alleged abuse here in the area. And one more thing, that independent review board will be meeting again tomorrow morning at 7:30. Reporting live in Southwest Miami-Dade, Angela Rozier, WPBF 25.